Well, this opens up a whole new dawn in physics and astrophysics. It's the first time we've been able to link the detection of gravitational waves to the light radiation that we can see. And if you detect something in light, you can see exactly which galaxy it's in. So what we think has happened here is the two merging neutron stars have merged together. They emit gravitational waves over a period of 20 to 30 seconds. They eject matter, and that matter is almost certainly the source of elements in the periodic table that are heavier than iron. For many years we've debated what the origin of those elements are, and the data we've taken at with our telescopes in the southern hemisphere in particular, that shows that the object gave out a lot of heat radiation. It faded very rapidly, and we see signatures in the spectrum of these elements heavier than iron, so things like cesium and tellurium would produce the emission. And even elements as heavy as gold and platinum. So I think this opens up for the first time a new way of finding objects in the sky. And of course it shows that Einstein 100 years ago, when he predicted that gravitational waves exist, not only have we shown that they exist, but we can actually identify the exact object that produced them.